Warning. This experiment uses corrosive hydrochloric acid. Wear gloves when handling it. We also use toxic chlorine gas. Work outside or in a fume hood. Greetings, fellow nerds. In a previous video, we've dissolved platinum with a mixture of hydrochloric and nitric acids known as Aqua Regia. While this works very well, nitric acid is somewhat expensive and not that easy to obtain. A much cheaper reagent for dissolving platinum is chlorine gas. To do this is actually pretty simple. Here I have a jar and in front you can see a vial containing 3 milliliters of hydrochloric acid and 337 milligrams of platinum metal powder. This is actually the same platinum metal powder we made in a previous video on refining platinum. Now in the back of the jar there is 3 vials containing 3 grams each of trichloroisocyanuric acid in 10 milliliters each of water. Trichloroisocyanuric acid is sold as a swimming pool chemical. These will serve to generate our chlorine gas. It's a huge access, but that's because we're working on a small scale with a relatively large reaction vessel that we need to fill with chlorine. Now I have my 4 vials in a jar here so I can seal it later and keep the chlorine gas in. If you're using a proper gas bubbling setup with little dead space and a very controlled gas generator, I recommend using an equal mass of trichloroisocyanuric acid to platinum for better reagent efficiency. Okay, let's get started. I'm opening up the jar and now I'm dropping in 1 milliliter of hydrochloric acid into each of the 3 vials containing the trichloroisocyanuric acid. This forms chlorine gas and I talked about the chemistry of that in a previous video. You can check in the video description to see it. Now let me seal the jar and turn on the stirring. You can see a slight yellowish green haze in the jar as the chlorine is produced and fills it. The lid is loose enough that chlorine can escape if the pressure is too high. Anyway, what's happening in our solution is that the platinum is reacting with the chlorine and hydrochloric acid to produce hexachloroplatinic acid, also known as chloroplatinic acid. Okay, it's been 20 minutes now and the water vapor is condensed on the side of the jar. Let me flame heat the jar to boil off the water so we can see it better. Let me turn off the stirring and let the platinum settle. You can see the solution is now orange. This is the color of hexachloroplatinic acid and proves our reaction is working. Okay, let me turn the stirring back on to let it continue. Now this process of using chlorine instead of nitric acid is advantageous for several reasons. As a raw chemical, nitric acid is somewhat more expensive than chlorine. So industrial scale refiners can have significant cost savings. Another issue that makes nitric acid even more expensive to use is that nitric acid also decomposes in Aqua Regia through various side reactions. These reactions deplete the nitric acid that otherwise would go dissolving platinum. You end up needing even more nitric acid than the ideal chemical equations require. Chlorine and hydrochloric acid have no depleting side reactions. So all the chlorine that's used in the target reaction is all that's actually needed, further saving costs. This is especially important in platinum that takes a long time to dissolve, like bulk platinum items or platinum embedded in other materials. If it takes too long, then the nitric acid decomposes by itself and you need to keep adding more. With chlorine, you just need to wait longer. You don't have to add more than the minimum you need. Now another problem when using nitric acid is that excess nitric acid in the resulting hexachloroplatinic acid has to be destroyed. It cannot be recovered and recycled. Excess chlorine gas, however, can easily be boiled out of the solution and recompressed to be recycled. Not having excess nitric acid to destroy saves considerable time and effort in processing the hexachloroplatinic acid. The chlorine doesn't even have to be bought. It can also be made by directly electrolyzing the hydrochloric acid in solution using graphite electrodes. I didn't do that for this experiment, however, because I want my hexachloroplatinic acid pure and don't want bits of graphite floating in it. There is, however, one very big and obvious drawback of using chlorine over nitric acid. It's a deadly toxic gas and thus difficult to handle compared to a liquid. It doesn't dissolve very much in solution, so you need to continuously expose it as the reaction progresses. This requires a complicated gas bubbling setup. For very small scales like this 337 milligrams quantity of platinum, we can use a single sealed jar. But if we scale up, we'll need ever more complicated apparatus. Industrial refiners have no problem dealing with gases, but amateur refiners usually shy away from them, and for good reason. Now you might be wondering if we can dissolve gold this way. We can, and I might try that in the future if there's enough interest. Anyway, here we are a few hours later and all the platinum has dissolved. This was much faster than dissolving our platinum bar because we're using fine powder with high surface area. Chlorine gas isn't particularly faster than nitric acid. we now have a relatively pure solution of hexachloroplatinic acid. There's also hydrochloric acid, but for my purposes I can use this as is. If you need to remove the hydrochloric acid, you can easily boil, evaporate, or distill it off. Anyway, that's how you dissolve platinum with chlorine gas and hydrochloric acid. Thanks for watching. Special thank you to all of my supporters on Patreon for making these science videos possible with their donations and their direction. If you're not currently a patron but would like to support the continued production of science videos like this one, then check out my Patreon page here or in the video description. I really appreciate any and all support.